Welcome. Welcome back to Legal and Ethical Environment of Business. This is Professor Guerra-Pujol at the University of Central Florida, and welcome. Welcome now to Module 4. In honor of LeBron James winning his fourth championship, this time with the Los Angeles Lakers, I began a little bit out of the Tiger King area, but I did play Yo Gotti, LeBron James. That is a clean version featuring Meek Mill. Great song, check it out, highly recommend it. So now I wanna jump into Module 4 and talk about the law of ideas. So what I'll do is I'll provide a general overview and then we'll jump into various types of intellectual property rights, which is what I mean by the law of ideas. But before I begin, I want to ask you two questions. One is, have you ever created intellectual property? And two, have you ever infringed intellectual property rights of others? Just throwing it out there, these are more, these questions are not designed to be judgy or judgmental or critical. It's designed to be more in a fun spirit. Speaking of the second question, I'll be the first to admit I am a huge offender. In almost all of my videos, I'll begin with a song, you know, copyrighted, protected song. Back when this course was lecture capture format, before pre-pandemic days, I would have not so much PowerPoints, but you know, picture prompts, slide presentations with lots of images that I would just grab off, you know, screen shares or screenshots. I would just grab off the internet. And so I just want to throw that out there and see, you know, have everybody ask and answer that question. Well, what are the main areas of intellectual property rights? We're going to see that there are four big areas, though I'm going to lump the first two areas, patents and trade secrets, into one sort of big area. So as I just said, we have patents and trade secrets, but we also have trademarks and copyrights. So altogether, we have four big areas of intellectual property rights. What I'm going to do, and by the way, I call it the law of ideas, which I think sounds less intimidating than the term intellectual property, because what ultimately these areas of law are doing, the reason why I lump them all together is because it's an area of law that allows you to, if you have an idea, it allows you to protect that idea. Or if you have a way of expressing an idea or branding an idea, again, the law will allow you to assert property rights. And that's you know, over your idea, over the expression of your idea. This is really, really important. It's how basically in a capitalist system, if you have an idea, it's how you protect the idea. It's how you can get rich or how you can build a business. So it's really, really important. And even if you work for a business or, you know, we're looking at an established business, sort of the big businesses like Apple, Amazon, Google, Facebook, they all own or have acquired, or in some cases, alleged to have stolen intellectual property rights. So a really, really important area of law. When it comes to Tiger King, intellectual property, really focusing on trademarks and copyrights, and trademark and copyright infringement or allegations of infringement, that's going to be the downfall of Joe Exotic. It's going to be, or I should say, the beginning of the downfall where his empire will begin to tumble. He is going to be, and I, by the way, have included in the introduction here to Module 4, a article or link to an article that was published in Tech Dirt, a trade publication, internet trade publication, that really gives you the details about the Joe Exotic case. It was actually two cases that Carol Baskin brought against Joe Exotic. One involving trademark infringement for the Big Cat Rescue logo. And I've included, by the way, in your module, the original registration, trademark registration of Big Cat Rescue, so you can see it for yourself. But also, Carol Baskin, Big Cat Rescue, they also brought a copyright infringement case because Joe Exotic had used, without permission, a copyrighted photo, which is going to take us later. I'll talk about fair use, what the likely outcome of that case might have been. So here's what we're going to do. We are going to actually look at each one of these areas of intellectual property. But first, what I want to do is look at patents and trademarks, inventions, ideas, formulas, recipes, etc., that you may have that you can actually take steps to legally protect. Let's begin there. I know for a fact Tiger King does not, you know, really talk about patents or trade secrets. So in my next video, I'm going to take a digression. I'm going to show you Google's first patent. I'll talk a little bit about the allegations involving Facebook that they stole trade secrets belonging to fellow classmates Tyler and Cameron Winklevoss. So I think you're really going to enjoy the next video. After that, we'll talk about trademark law and copyrights. And what I'll do is just to proceed in a logical fashion, I'll first explain how you can establish and create these intellectual property rights, what they are, what they cover, what they protect, and how you create them, or how you assert legal rights over them. And then we'll talk about on the infringement side, and that'll bring us back to Tiger King. And there are some other really great cases in our textbook that I'll talk about, including whether Google is now a generic trademark, since we use Google basically as a verb to describe internet search generally, whether the Barbie case involving a very famous song, the lyrics of which refer to Barbie, does that create, is that infringement? We'll also look at copyright infringement as well, fair use. So we'll be doing a lot of stuff. Sorry for the long introduction, but I want to get everybody revved up. This is a really important area of law. So without further ado, I'll pause. This will give you a chance to take a break, grab a Coke or a Pepsi or a cup of coffee or a glass of water or something healthy, a juice, and we'll jump into patents and trade secrets in our next video. Thank you for your attention. See you soon.